Hello, beautiful people of the internet. I'm back with a little tutorial on how you can install shaders in Minecraft 1.14. Or to be more accurate, in 1.14.3. If you're using a newer version than that, for example 1.14.4, the process should still be similar and this tutorial might still be useful for you. Okay, let's get right into it. First, you need to have Minecraft installed, obviously. But you also need to have started Minecraft in version 1.14.3 at least once, so that the version is already downloaded onto your computer by the Minecraft launcher. It's the same for other versions, like a future version 1.14.4. In that case, you would need to start Minecraft in version 1.14.4 at least once. If you don't have a 1.14.3 installation yet and don't know how to add it to the launcher, I will give you a quick step-by-step guide now. If you already have one, that's good and you can skip forward in the video to the time that is now shown on the screen. Okay, in order to add a new Minecraft version to your launcher, you just need to select Minecraft Java Edition on the left here and then click on Installations up here on the top. And now you click on the New button to create an installation. After you have done that, this little window will open. Give the installation a name like 1.14.3, for example, and select the Minecraft version over here. In our case, we want to use 1.14.3, but in the future you might want to select 1.14.4 or another future version. Now, after you click on the Create button, the new installation will appear in your list of installations. Remember to start the game with version 1.14.3 at least once. In order to do that, just click on the Play button down here. And now Minecraft will load using that version and download all the needed files. After you get to the main menu, this part is over and you're ready to go to the next step. Now, before you can proceed with installing Optifine, which is the mod you will need to run the shaders, you have to make sure that you have Java installed on your computer. If you are not sure if Java is already installed, you can just install it regardless, and in the worst case you'll just end up with a newer Java version. Now I'll give you a quick guide on how you can install Java. However, if you already have it installed or know how to do it yourself, you can skip the video to the time now shown on the screen. In order to install Java, you need to know which type of operating system is running on your computer. If you have a modern PC, it's probably going to be a 64-bit operating system. But if you want to check, just to be sure, you can do so under Windows by opening your Windows Explorer and right-click on This PC and then on Properties. Now this window with information about your system will open. You can see here that my computer uses a 64-bit operating system. After you know your operating system, you can go to java.com and download the Java version for your operating system. I will also put a link to the website into the video description. If you have a Windows 64-bit system, you would download this Windows 64-bit version. And if you have a Windows 32-bit one, you can use this link here. After you have completed the download, just check your downloads folder for the file and open it. A window will open and there you can click on Install and go through the installation process. For me, since I already have older Java versions installed, it first wants to uninstall them, which I will quickly do, and after that the installation process is also pretty much over. Now with Java installed, all that's left is for you to download the mod Optifine, which enables you to use shaders and, as a bonus, makes Minecraft run much smoother as well. You can find the mod on optifine.net. The link to this website is also down in the video description. Once you're on the website, you have to click on Downloads and there you have different Optifine versions for different Minecraft versions. In our case, we want the version Optifine 1.14.3, which is for our Minecraft version. Any future versions of Optifine, for example for 1.14.4, would be on this page as well. In order to download Optifine, you can use either the download or the mirror link. I would suggest using the mirror, which is something like an alternative download link. The main download link will first send you over to AdFly, which will show you some pretty dodgy ads at times. After clicking on the mirror link, you have to click on Download Optifine once more and wait until the download is finished. You may receive a little warning from your browser about the file, because browsers apparently don't like jar files. But don't worry about that, Optifine is a widely used mod and perfectly safe to use, so you can just simply click on keep. Now go into your downloads folder and find the Optifine file. If you have Java installed, the file should show this little Java coffee pot as an icon. But if you are sure that you already have Java installed and it still doesn't show this little coffee pot icon, Windows may have set a different program than Java to open .jar files like these. In order to fix that, just right-click the file, then click on Open With and select Java Platform SE Binary in the list. If it's not there in the list, click on Choose Another App and look for it there. Well, if it's not there either, click on Look for Another App on this PC. Then go into your folder Broken Files, which will probably already open when you click on the button, and then go in the folder Java. Here open your Java version folder, go into the bin folder and select Java WX. Now you just need to click on open. If Optifine opened for you and you see this window, that's great and you can now skip to the time shown on screen. Otherwise, if nothing happens or you get an error, I will now go over a few things you can do to fix that. When opening the Optifine file, a little error message may appear. This can happen if another program on your PC has already taken the association for .jar files, which is very possible under Windows, especially if you have programs like WinRAR installed. In order to fix this problem, you need to download a small program called JarFix. A download link to the program is in the description. Just download it and run it, and it will fix the association for .jar files and hopefully remove the error. If nothing happens when you double-click on the Optifine file, you can try executing the file with Java directly over the command line. In Windows, you can do that very easily. Just go to the folder where your Optifine file is located, which is probably your downloads folder. Then click on the file path up here in your Windows Explorer and write cmd. After pressing enter, the Windows terminal will open. Now you just need to write java-jar and the name of the file, which is in our case optifine_1.14.3_hd_u_f1.jar. After you have opened the Optifine file, a little window will appear. If you had already started Minecraft 1.14.3 once, as we did back in step 1, then you can just click on install here and Optifine will do its thing. You're pretty much done with the installation at this point. Now, when you open Minecraft, you might already have an installation for Optifine, which you can select down here in the drop-down menu or under the installations tab. But if there's none, you can simply create the Optifine installation yourself. Just click on New in the Installations tab. Then put down a name like 1.14.3 Optifine. Then select Optifine in the versions list here on the side and click on Create. Now you will have an Optifine installation in your list, which you can play. All that's left to do now is grabbing your favorite shader and installing that. For example, I will use one of Sildur's shaders, which I have been using in some of my videos in the past. But you can use whatever shader you like, just make sure that it says that it works in 1.14. I will also put a link to a list of shaders down in the video description if you want to check it out. Anyway, to get Sildur's shader, go to this website, link in the description as well, and download the shader version that you want. I will choose version 1.22 high for this example, but if your computer is on the slower end, you might want to use 1.22 light instead. There is only one download link here for every version and all of them go over Adfly, so you have to deal with some interesting ads. Well, deny this little notification pop-up and just wait for 5 seconds. After that, you need to click on the yellow button in the top right corner saying skip ad. Well, it says Werbung überspringen here for me, because the site detects that I'm German, but it will be different for you. Anyway, after the download is finished, you are going to get a nice little .zip file containing the shader. You shouldn't unzip this file, just leave it as it is and open Minecraft. Then, in the Minecraft main menu, you have to click on Options, Video Settings, and then on Shaders. Now, within this Shaders menu, you have a button called Shaders folder. If you click on that, a folder will open in which you have to place your shader.zip file. Well, I will just go ahead and drag and drop it in there. After you have done this, the shader will appear in the shader menu inside Minecraft. Select the shader by clicking on it and it will be loaded. After you have selected the shader, you can adjust some settings here on the side and even more stuff by opening the shader options down here, if you want to do so. However, the shader should run just fine with the default settings. Now, after you click on Done, the shader is loaded and will be running when you open a Minecraft world. Now, everything looks fancy and beautiful. Anyway, that's pretty much it for this little tutorial. If you found it helpful, consider giving this video a like or even subscribe if you want to see some future Minecraft creations from me. Because I also create stuff like Minecraft functions and Minecraft commands, occasionally, so you might want to check that out. Anyway, I am out. Ciao. See ya.